Howdy, Ags. My name is Logan Wharton, and we're Gucci Gang. Today, we're going to be explaining education and population in Texas. While technology continues to move at a rapid pace, the importance to create and innovate new technologies lies within us. Also, with singularity on the horizon, Texas is drastically changing and constantly growing in population. For those of y'all who might not know what singularity means, it's defined as the state, fact, or condition of being singular. With that being said, I'd like to introduce some current trends in Texas. For example, did you know that Texas is going to grow from 25 million to roughly 55 million by 2050? I mean, just sit back and think about that for a second. We're going to need a lot more HEBs to feed people. And just get this, right now, on average, there are about 2,000 people a day packing up everything they own and moving to Texas. I mean, who the hell wouldn't want to move here, though? Everything's bigger and better in Texas. As of right now, Houston, Austin, and Dallas are among the top 10 contenders with the fastest wage growth in Texas, or in the U.S. One more interesting trend that I'd like to add in there is the Business Insider on July 21st, 2015, added that Houston and Austin were ranked number one and two for the best cities for people in the science and tech industry in the U.S. And for my last interesting trend I'd like to share before we move on is that Forbes magazine named Austin the number one city for the trendiest city in America. Thank you, and now I'm going to introduce Jesse, and he's going to be discussing some of the issues we have in Texas. Thank you. Dig him.
Howdy, Eggs. I'm here to discuss a few of the current issues here in Texas. Texas has the largest population of citizens without health insurance in the United States. Texas is ranked 47 in overall health care quality. Texas falls significantly below the national average in such categories as patient safety, healthy living, HIV/AIDS, nursing homes, etc. Texas school funding stands alone as worst in the United States. Latest edition of Is School Funding Fair? The effects of large population growth. Overcrowding of classrooms. Today, around 1.5 million students are enrolled in colleges and universities. There will be less teachers in larger classrooms. Minimum level of teaching credentials would lower increased need, overall lowering the quality of education. Increasing in zoning segregation. Already poor areas will only become more poor. Example, inner cities. Many schools won't be able to pay for larger facilities and larger classrooms. More funds spent on transportation due to an increasing need for buses and longer routes. Population's effect on education. Population. Texas will be responsible for 25% of the growth in United States population in just 30 years. What cities will house these people? Houston, Dallas, San Antonio, Austin? Maybe. Immigration is the biggest factor on how the population growth in Texas and how it will grow. Hispanics, Asians play the largest role on which ethnic groups are immigrating to Texas. How will schools, elementary, high school, universities, etc., handle these amounts of students? Who will fund and build the amount of institutions we need to house these students and provide a proper education for them? Now to speak a little on education. Not enough room for support, the amount of students now or near in the future. A list provided by Texas Higher Education's data website that lists there are a total of 147 institutions of higher learning and over 1.5 million enrolled in a loan of these institutions. Texas is 40th in the U.S. education. If our population is going to increase by double in the next three decades from 27 million to 55 million, how will our education systems be able to handle this amount? Our government does not want to pay. Texas is almost dead last when it comes to school funding in the United States. Education is funded by taxes. Texans are generally against tax increases, seeing how it's a Republican state. Increases in population tax base does not necessarily mean the funding will be proportional. Districts across the state no doubt want funding to be front and center in this session. But the Texas Supreme Court didn't do them any favors by ruling in May that the school finance system was constitutional. So how will we contract companies to build us new institutions? I will further allow Denny to speak on that. Thank you.
For our solution, we decided to do a virtual classroom, and what a virtual classroom is, it is a teaching and learning environment where participants can interact, communicate, view and discuss presentations, and engage with learning resources while working in groups all in an online setting. So we put together pros and cons for our virtual classroom, and our pros are we are still going to have teachers, and by having these teachers, we will still be learning in a more efficient way. By having webcams in the classroom, the attendance will be more verified. All of the transportation will be eliminated, which allows less congestion on the road, so there won't be car lines and bus lines. The schools will no longer be in the building, so the students will be able to learn wherever they're most comfortable, in their house, at a park, or with just friends. Because of not having extracurricular activities, businesses can start and thrive. Even in the advent of singularity, we aren't able to predict accurately on how the virtual classrooms will perform, so there might be these cons. All the classrooms might use a lot of internet access, so it might be slow at times. There are going to be a lot more funds. There could possibly be more academic dishonesty with having students do more online things. Something could go wrong with the technology and mess up unexpectedly. Some students might get distracted and not be 100% focused on the assignments, and some of the kids might not get as much interaction as they would hope to than in a regular classroom.
Hi, my name is Catherine, and I will be concluding what we've talked about in our topic on population and education and how that really relates to singularity. So now that Logan has introduced us to our topic and really defined what singularity is, and how our topics of population and education relate to singularity, and some of these current trends, including how Texas will grow from 25 million to 55 million by 2050, and how around 2,000 people are moving into Texas every day. Texas is also said to be one of the most productive places in America. And with these current trends, we have to sit here and wonder, what will the future of Texas really look like? So involved in looking at what the future of Texas look like, Jesse introduced us to some of these issues that Texas currently has. And some of the issues we are facing today as a state is how a large amount of our population is without health insurance. And Texas is ranked 47th in overall health care quality. And for having 50 states, that's really low. It also falls significantly below the national average in categories that are widely important for the best wishes and the best health and happiness of citizens, such as patient safety, healthy living, HIV, AIDS, etc. Another large issue that Texas faces is its education system. And the effects of these issues are there's huge overcrowding in classrooms, and as the population grows and more kids are needed to be educated, more people are going to college, there is less teachers, and that leads to larger classrooms where kids aren't always getting the one-on-one attention they're needing. And as the need for teaching increases, the demand for teachers is so strong that we're starting to take teachers with less and less credentials. In addition, these issues of education and population really make us look at how are we going to pay and provide for these kids going to school? How are we going to pay and help the population be up to standard? Jesse also introduced us to Danny, who presented us with a solution to our problems of education and population within the advent of singularity. And the solution that we discovered and discussed was virtual classrooms. A virtual classroom is defined as a teaching and learning environment where participants can interact, communicate, view and discuss presentations, and engage with learning resources while working in groups, and all of this is in an online setting. Now that I've concluded everything, once again, my name is Catherine, and we thank you, Team 2, Gucci Gang, for listening to our issues and the solution that we found in the advent of singularity. Thanks, and giggle.